sites. I don't think that the brine water coming from Pennsylvania, New York, and West Virginia is near those drilling sites. We're getting dumped on here in Ohio, and the injection wells are the issue. There's a report out from the state of New York that had a moratorium for 2 years. There's a list of chemicals that are clearly listed as chemicals, you know, not the trade secret names that they use on the MSDS sheets. I've worked with our safety forces. I had a visit there yesterday with the chief and the active duty crew members. They don't know what's in the toxic brine. And we can call it benign brine. There's over 150 chemicals in it, and over 50 of them are toxic to humans. And the concentrations are extremely severe. So it's more like the ends don't justify the means. On one end, we have freshwater consumption that will not be returned to the hydrological cycle. And on the other end, we have millions and millions of gallons of toxic waste that's already being brought here from out of state. And as the drilling progresses, we're going to have millions and millions of our own gallons of toxic waste. You know, those of us that are concerned about this issue, there's a multi-state coalition that's working between Michigan, Ohio, Pennsylvania, West Virginia, New York. And what we're saying is keep your own wastewater. If you're drilling there and you're creating a toxic wastewater, keep your own wastewater. We have trucks that are coming from Texas withdrawing public water. If as long as it's under $100,000 a gallon today, they don't have to report it. These trucks are coming from Texas withdrawing our water and taking it to Pennsylvania for drilling and drying. And then we get it back. Can you guarantee that it'll never migrate behind you beyond your 5 acre site? How much water can you sub into 5 acres before it does begin to migrate into other areas? Other rock fishes.
Not to mention the 6,000 holes they punched in the ground in 1982 alone.
Yeah.
6,000 holes in the ground. There's actually over 300,000 wells in the state of Ohio. Many of them are orphaned and unknown. And some of those are what's called class 5 wells, which pertain a lot to non-hazardous material, even sewage wells. The Ohio EPA has primacy over the class 5 wells. ODNR has full primacy over the class 2. Are they coordinating? Are they putting a class 2 well near another hole in the ground where that could cross-migrate and create a problem? The issue in Youngstown with the injection wells, they didn't know there was a fault there. They didn't know there was a fault until they drilled into the pre-campaign basement, and the chief of ODNR increased the pressure over a several-day period until there was a seismic activity. I don't think they'll ever know. At 9 to 10,000 feet into the basement, they call it. I don't think they'll ever know. Is that a time indicator?
No.
Okay. Let's go with the question.
What was the question?
The question was, can I name the case of contaminated drinking water from fracking? And I would say, number one, you know, Ms. Rita said that the hydraulic fracturing process was just a moment in time of 1 or 2 days. So when you say fracturing, you mean the process from beginning to end, cradle to grave. There are many, many documented cases. Unfortunately, what happens is in Pennsylvania, Bradford County, in northeastern Pennsylvania, when these folks run out of water, industry will come in and offer them water under a gag order. They cannot report that their water's been contaminated. There are many cases out there, great PR by the industry, and I really wish that some of these kind of presentations would be more addressable. I could say this. Cases, yes.
I would like to back that up by saying that the EPA study that's being conducted on the federal level, they did a study of Papillion, Wyoming, and concluded that the same chemicals used in the fracturing process were in the water wells of many residents, and concluded that it was from the process of oil and gas drilling.
But not hydraulic fracturing. If you go back,
right,
they've
right.
changed
that. That's two separate. That's two separate
energy
things.
Energy Dep file, yeah. And it clearly restates all the facts, including what the EPA.
Specific. specifically fracking is a separate thing than the whole. The whole issue is different than the immediate time of fracturing. So she'll say that the fracturing point never caused water contamination, but the conclusion that's been reached is that the whole process is causing the problem.
The other issue that I want to talk about, I'll bring up very briefly, and then I'll ask you some questions or move on. And this was brought up with our safety forces, is the hydrogen sulfide issue. Ohio says there's a map here. Ohio says 2/3 of the state sits over a hydrogen sulfide pocket, which is extremely dangerous to humans. And that's one of those issues that I think our safety forces really need to address. We had an incident in Mexico where there was a brine truck sitting by the racetrack, and they were bending out a pipe, and there was liquid spilling into it. It was open, unsupervised. So we're all part of our path.
Our safety forces are trained on hydrogen sulfide. You have to keep in mind that a lot of those different sources of hydrogen sulfide. We probably have lost more
industry workers and firefighters in the dust or something or something else. We're going to ask about what, 400 years or something?
Very limited areas in the state of Ohio.
Because it was real, answer a question. What do you think about this?
Does OOGDEP offer something on their site to educate folks on this?
As far as the drilling site, actually, H2SOC, right. But you can go on the ODNR and you can find the prevalent counties and their special permit that was done. If it is H2S, there's also a, and I don't call it a response trailer, there is a trailer that Fuji and Uga Industry put together. It's a baler. It has monitoring equipment on it. It has spades to disperse them should they be working on it. So in the baler,
last thing that I would like to say is, you know, for the most part, it was a great history lesson, but I really would like to see more focus on the last 10 to 15 years of development. I think that would be more beneficial to educate folks. When you say we've been doing it for 60 years, we weren't using this volume and the number of chemicals 60 years ago.
Single incident.
No, I know.